Hello everyone. Today we are going to talk about the drainage system of our body, the urinary system. Hi, I'm Ume, and before we start, please subscribe to our channel so the next time you'll be updated with our new releases. The urinary system is considered your body drainage system for removing urine, which consists of water and waste products. The urinary system consists of two kidneys. They remove waste products and drugs from the body, maintain fluid balance in the body, release specific hormones to regulate blood pressure, and have a role in the production of red blood cells. Both kidneys remove a harmful substance from the blood called urea through their tiny filtering units called nephrons. Two ureters. They are narrow tubes that carry the urine from the kidneys to the bladder. The ureters have muscles in their walls that continuously contract and relax to force the urine down to bladder. The urinary bladder, it is a triangle-shaped hollow organ that lies in the lower abdomen. It is fixed in its place by ligaments that are attached to the pelvic bones and other organs. The bladder works by relaxing and expanding to accommodate more amounts of urine and then contracting to empty the stored amount of urine. Two sphincter muscles. These are two circular muscles that close tightly around the opening of the bladder like a rubber band to prevent urine from leaking. The urethra. It is a tube that allows urine to flow out of the body. Our role today is to answer most of your questions regarding urinary disorder. Today we have Dr. Yoon, who is a leading doctor at Ewha Women's University Hospital in Seoul. She is going to discuss with us about urinary disorder from an experienced medical point of view. Hello, Dr. Yoon. Thank you for coming. Dr. Yoon, what is urinary disorder in men and women?
Men and women's urinary disorders deal with everything related to urination. Some may have a hard time controlling the urge to urinate. Some may experience frequent urge to urinate. And some may have a hard time releasing urine in full flow. Some may have a weak ureter, etc. There are many symptoms to consider, but basically, if someone has difficulty urinating or controlling, can be lumped as urinary disorders. Men and women can both have it. Age is irrelevant, as the old and young can both get it.
So what are the main types of this disorder?
Usually for men, the issues are prostate-related. The prostate is below the bladder. If the prostate is inflamed, there might be discomfort and issues urinating. Women don't have a prostate. Instead, the ureter is short and more delicate, and is surrounded by many organs and are subject to more attacks by bacteria. Thus, women tend to be more likely to develop urinary disorders. So women are subject to bladder inflammation, incontinence, and many other issues involving the bladder.
So enuresis, what is it and what are the type of it and what causes it?
Normally, we go to sleep and urinate when we wake up. With enuresis, instead of going to urinate, waking up in the middle of the night, bedwetting happens. Urination happens without any self-control. While normally we get up at night if we feel like urinating, but with enuresis, it happens on its own. As kids grow up, they normally control urination, but some keep bedwetting due to a lack of hormone that regulates this control. Or as older adults, instead of being able to control the urination at will, with enuresis, bedwetting happens with constant urination and lack of control. So both adults and the young can have enuresis.
So why is diagnosis needed in this case?
The reason we need diagnosis is because, for example, with bladder inflammation, if it lasts, we get stressed from inflammation and pain associated with bladder infection. Likewise, the bladder undergoes continued pain. Such patients go to the restroom often and the bladder deteriorates. Life quality suffers fast. In some extreme cases, the bladder becomes hardened and useless and may need surgery to remove it. So in order to prevent these terrible outcomes, we need to diagnose early. And with prostate issues, it can even affect the kidneys. In order to prevent the kidneys suffering, we need to diagnose it early.
So are there any treatments or a prevention way of enuresis?
We can treat enuresis in two ways. One is when urination happens without control overnight, also known as bedwetting. We can prescribe drugs to kids to disable urination while sleeping, until the patient is woken up in the morning to urinate. For adults, we can prescribe drugs called antidiuretic hormones to limit the body from making too much urine at night while asleep. Some may need this hormone as the body lacks the ample production for some. Some can benefit from these treatments.
So what is exactly neurogenic bladder?
Neurogenic bladder is when the nervous system that controls muscle movements is in disarray or compromised. Neurogenic bladder can happen due to a variety of causes. It can affect the bladder to lose control or not be able to perform its function at all. Neurogenic bladder can happen due to diabetes, stroke, damage to the spine from car accidents, and these damages to the nervous system can affect negatively. It can also happen due to cancer treatments that may have damaged the nervous system.
What kind of treatment methods exist for this kind of disease?
Neurogenic bladder treatment depends on the root causes. For those with uncontrolled flow of urine, we can prescribe drugs to limit and control the flow. For those who cannot trigger urination, we can use drugs to encourage free flow of urine. There are situations where drugs are not possible. For example, a patient with damage to the kidneys. We can use a treatment called intermittent catheterization to help empty the bladder every 3 to 4 hours. We can use various techniques, but we cannot yet utilize robotic assets as the urination process is internal. Although such assist robotic wear can help those rehabilitate for walking, for example.
So before treatments, how do you diagnose the case of?
First, the patient's history is important, whether he has diabetes, stroke, or trauma from accidents. It is important to know if there is damage to the nervous system. We also test for the bladder's link to the nervous system to see if it works as intended. We can use nerve response tests.
Men and women's urinary disorder deal with everything related to urination. Some may have a hard time controlling the urge to urinate, some may experience frequent urge to urinate, and some may have a hard time releasing urine in full flow. Some may have a weaker ureter, etc. There are many symptoms to consider, but basically, if someone has difficulty urinating or controlling, can be lumped as urinary disorder. People can get urinary disorder regardless of gender and age. Usually for men, the issues are prostate related. The prostate is below the bladder. If the prostate is inflamed, there might be discomfort and issues urinating. Women don't have a prostate. Instead, the ureter is shorter and more delicate and is surrounded by many organs and are subject to more attacks by bacteria. Thus, women tend to be more likely to develop urinary disorders. So, women are subject to bladder inflammation, incontinence, and many other issues involving the bladder. Neurogenic bladder is when the nervous system that controls muscle movement is in disarray or compromised. Neurogenic bladder can happen due to a variety of causes. Can affect the bladder to lose control or not to be able to perform its function. Neurogenic bladder can happen due to diabetes, stroke, damage to the spine from a car accident, and these damages to the nervous system can affect negatively. It can also happen due to cancer treatment that may have damaged the nervous system. Thank you everyone for joining us in yet another video covering key health-related topics with Cloud Hospital TV. If you have any questions or comments, please leave it below and we'll respond to you as soon as we can.